Hi guys, welcome to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. And if you've been here before, then welcome back. I just want to quickly share the books that I've been reading and actually been making an impact in my life and have been changing my life. So, without any delay, let's get into it. Okay, before then,
How much just your legs?
I read it and I used to read before, like in my teens, I used to read books, and the books I used to read were just like love novels, just reading for entertainment. But not knowing that there was a whole world of books that's existing, and if you start to read, you will start to see so many changes in your life about things, reading developmental books, inspirational books, motivational books. So, with that being said, after that period, like now, so when I started to read the very first book I read, it was Chicken Soup for the Soul. My God, that book, let me say, for me, it was a turnaround for me. So because I was at a place that I was so bored about everything, and like, why can I do, how will I do this, and I did not really have any direction or goal of what I want to do. So I started a book. The book talks about, it's called Chicken Soup for the Soul by Jack Canfield. It talks about how you can find inspiration, how you can set visions for your life, set a goal for your life, and just see yourself as a different person. And one of the key principles that the book teaches that is so much is that your response to everything about life gives you the output. So no matter where you are, no matter what happened to you, if something did happen, someone did treat you bad or so, it is your decision to do what you want to do that will make the difference. So you are the master of your own decision. What you decide to do has a real great impact you positively or impact you negatively. So that was the lesson. And another cool lesson in the book is, don't say you are going to wait for things to change, that you are going to wait for your children to come out of high school, wait to get a job, you are going to wait to get back in school before you be happy or before you start to experience the joy of life. That even where you are at that particular time, like right now, where I am right now, I can be happy. I can choose to be happy, and it is a decision. So for me, I was at that kind of person. I was always waiting for someone to make me happy. I did not really accept myself as a person. I did not really love myself, like accepting myself just for who I am. I was always waiting for someone outside to come and love me. And I'm in the process of loving myself, and I'm grateful because where it was so bad. I really did not like myself at all. So coming from that point now, that you decide what you want to do. If no one treats you well, treat yourself well, and you'll be able to treat other people well. So that book was eye-opening for me. I'm so grateful that I read. And the next book that really did change my life again is called On the Power of Now. So with being that kind of anxious person who always worry about the future of things that will happen and worrying about the past of things that did happen, like things that did not do, were mistakes that I made, and I tried to hold on to it. So being that kind of person with so much anxiety, worrying every time about what people thinking about me, what will someone say about me, reading that Power of Now, that don't think about the future, don't think about the past. You can plan for the future and you can learn from the past, but the place where you can live your life is within the now. So that just changed my life. Just knowing that I have the power to change my life, it just like I have the power to be present. Even it is written that what you have, like that's a quote also that says that your prayer, your future, let's say tomorrow is not promised, yesterday is gone. And so that those are the books that have really been teaching my life as the Power of Now. It's just a book that is centered around you being present in the moment, that no matter where you are, how you can start being track of being a person. So let me just take a little down journey into it. So it's like this: the mind works in a way that you worry too much about the future, not yet, and has not yet come. You worry too much about the past, about things that have passed. So in that state, the mind works with an ego that make you to not be present, denying the fact of everything that is before you and just worrying about the future. So in our state, it brings so much anxiety, it brings so much stress, it brings too much worrying, because you are worrying about things that actually are not as if they are actually there. Maybe you are worried about to take your test, but you are worrying that you may fail the test, you might fail the test, or you are worried that you'll not be able to keep that promise, or you'll not be able to make that thing, you'll not be able to finish it up. So you're just worried about things that are not, or it was in another way in the past. If you make a mistake, you always dwell on that mistake, thinking about what should have been, how it should have been, instead of accepting the fact that it has already happened. So reading that book just opened up my mind. I was like, wow. You mean like there's a whole world of knowledge that is existing outside of my usual thing that I usually do about reading books. So I've actually been enjoying the journey, and that's my promise, that's commitment I'm making to myself, to make reading to be a habit, that I can even possibly read one book per day. That would be so gorgeously great. And another book also that I read, and it actually gave me a whole new perspective also, is Act Like a Lady and Think Like a Man. So that book, so much great about relationship. I did not know, for me, in relationship, because of that will to like try to please people, what would somebody say about me, not being too happy about, not really loving myself in the first place, and coming from that point. So I always try to take all of that and put it on someone to say, okay, you have to love me, you have to show me that I'm important, you have to value me, you have to care for me. And I really did not know how to relate to people in and love in that way. So reading that book just gave me a whole new perspective about relationship. How the lesson in the book I'm going to share part of it is that men do work with ego. It's like this, the way men understand things, the way they do relate to things, that's not how we ladies relate to them. For us, we want love, we want care and concern, but for them, you have to show to them that you trust them, you have to understand, like appreciate them. So I really did not know that that was one of the core of men, that you have to appreciate them. So one of the example in the book, and that was actually written by Steve, I'll check his last name. So yeah, Steve, the one that got that American show, he's the one I wrote that book. So the American television show, one of the American television shows, and they were hosting it. So why it says is that, take for an example, if you wanted a pig pink in your living room, let's say in your kitchen, you wanted it to be pink with a pink paint on the wall, and then maybe he came and changed the paint to blue. Instead, he came to say, oh baby, I did not like this, why did you change this for me? I'm very not, just it will kill their ego, because they want to be in a position that they provide for you, that they care for you, they protect you. So once they are not receiving that from you, they feel like, is this really my lady? Is she my girl? So you should be in a position to show to them that you appreciate them, even if they do little things. I don't care how little those things are, you should be able to appreciate them. So reading that book just gave me so much joy. Like, it opened up my mind for relationship. I have different view now about relationship, about how I can relate to people. So these three books that I just listed, you can read them. It's going to do you too much good if you are the kind of person you want to grow, and like where I was, and you want change. You can actually start to incorporate that in your routine. Try to make reading to be part of you, the things that you do. You should be able to read, try to read that book, Chicken Soup for the Soul, if you have the time. And also read that Power of Now.